All right, so this problem says the average of 8 numbers is 6.5. If each of the numbers is decreased by 3, what is the average of the 8 new numbers? So this is actually going to follow along with a mathematical rule that will apply to all problems and that are like this. I'm going to go through an example first, then I'll explain what rule I'm talking about afterwards. So first of all, this says the average of 8 numbers is 6.5. So like with problems like this, like if I don't know a rule or know the rule specifically, I just like to like guess and check the problem. So like the best way to guess and check this is to come up with 8 numbers who, when you average them out, give you an average of 6.5. And it doesn't have to be like difficult. Like really, you can just do all 6.5s. I'm gonna do 4 higher and 4 lower that average out. So like for example, I'm gonna use the numbers 9.5, 9.5, 9.5. 9.5, and then 3.5, 3.5, 3.5, and 3.5. Okay, so if you add all these together and then divide them by 8, because that's how you find average or mean, you would add all these together and divide by 8, you would get 6.5. So the mean or the average of these would be 6.5. So that's your average. Okay, so this is my starting group of numbers. It says if each of the numbers is decreased by 3, what is the average of the 8 new numbers? So for that, all you're going to do is subtract 3 from every single number in your database. Okay, so that's like the rule that I'll talk about later. Every single number is being decreased by 3. So when I do that, my new numbers are now 6.5, 6.5, 6.5, 6.5, and then 0.5, 0.5, 0.5, 0.5, okay? So when I add all of these, now I'm gonna find the average of all these because it says what is the average of the 8 new numbers. So when I add all of these together, I will get 30, okay? So 30 is what I get when I get divide, or when I add all these together. So 30. And then to get my average, I'm still dividing by however many numbers I have, which is 8. So 30 divided by 8 gives you 3.5. Okay, so that means my average for my new data set is 3.5. So the answer to this problem specifically is B, because your new average is 3.5. But something to like avoid the work here, a rule that you can just remember is mean. There's three things: mean, median, and mode. Listen carefully to what I'm going to say here. These three, when every number in the data set is increased or decreased by a number, the overall mean, median, and mode will also increase or decrease by that number. So in this problem, we were decreasing every number by 3. So automatically, without working anything out, I know that I just take my average of my original, decrease by 3, I get my answer, okay? For any of these, like if they give you a problem and say, the median of 8 numbers is 4, everything goes up by 1, what's my new median? It would also go up by 1, it would be 5. So all of these go up by or down by whatever they have every number do. So this one was decreased by 3, so my average immediately decreases by 3. And then your range and interquartile range, these would actually stay the same. So if you have a problem like this where they give you everything increasing or decreasing by a certain amount, these stay the same. These go up or down by that certain amount. So if you need to rewatch that back to make that make sense, do it. But that's these three. If you see mean, median, or mode, and they tell you that every number is increasing or decreasing by a certain amount, you automatically know that the mean, median, or mode is also increasing or decreasing by that certain amount.